Digitalization, AI, Web3, these are just some of the buzzwords that have popped up in the last couple of years. But for an ordinary individual, there's only one concern about how companies are using these technologies, and that's how their data is being protected.
To talk to us about cybersecurity and data protection, we have with us in the studio via Zoom, Roren Marie Chin. She is the Public Information and Assistance Division Chief of the National Privacy Commission. Hi, Ms. Roren.
Hi, good evening to everyone, and thank you for inviting the National Privacy Commission to your to talk about data privacy and cybersecurity.
Right, you know what? In this day and age where everybody's on their phones a lot, making a lot more transactions online, people don't realize that their privacy is their wealth, right? They just give away a lot of private information to anybody, including OTP and all that stuff. So there's been a lot of scams, there's been a lot of data breaches, hurting many people's assets or wealth. What is the level of compliance now of different corporations when it comes to the law and your regulatory requirements?
Indeed, we were actually witnessing positive signs of improvement among companies and individuals that handle personal data, which we refer in National Privacy Commission as the Personal Information Controllers or PICs. One notable indicator is that there is already a progress is the increasing presence of privacy notice in various establishments, malls, schools, even in hotels and hospitals. And also when you go to the website of some companies, they have the privacy notice. And also this is also available on application, mobile application. So this privacy notice, it's very important. Positive indication that companies, PICs, are being serious when it comes to data privacy and making efforts to communicate with their clients, their customers, on how they process the data that they collect.
But what about their compliance with the staff or the expertise of these companies in preventing data breaches and in protecting their data assets, right? Not a lot of companies can afford or maybe do get cybersecurity experts in-house to make sure that your private the private information of its customers are protected.
Yes, we understand that there are also expense, complying to the requirements are also expensive. No, however, it was specified in the law that the cybersecurity or the security measures should be appropriate and reasonable when it comes to the amount of personal data that are also they are collecting. So they don't, companies or individuals who are collecting personal data doesn't have to spend so much as long as it's justifiable on how much they are willing to fund or provide a lot their funding when it comes to providing privacy and security when it with their personal data that they are collecting.
Just to follow up on that, the law does require that companies have their own, they call it data protection officers, is that correct? Okay.
Yes, sir.
How does the NPC or the government make sure that the company DPOs are well-educated and well-trained with their responsibilities?
The National Privacy Commission actually provides free trainings for our data protection officer. There are also private sectors who are providing trainings, and the National Privacy Commission right now has the registration of the data protection officer and also the system. So in this way, we can provide newsletters, provide them with trainings and updates on our circulars that we provide. So in this way, we ensure that DPOs of such companies, private or government, are well aware of what is going on with the National Privacy Commission and our circulars and issuances.
So you'd be able to say that 100% of corporations are complying, or is there a number that you can give us? And what's your biggest pain point when it comes to this?
Okay, maybe I will start with a concern or the National Privacy Commission is relatively small, a government agency. There are only 200 employees, more or less 200 employees, and our scope is all over the Philippines, and we are only here, based here in Pasay. So it's really difficult to communicate sometimes and reach those companies and PICs, individuals that are collecting and processing personal data. So as much as possible, we try to very aggressive, and we have our advocacy programs, our advocacy campaigns. Sometimes we conduct trainings and trainings all over the country. And right now, our compliance and monitoring division is actually going from one company to another company just to ensure not only private sectors, especially the LGUs, so that we also have another arm of support when spreading awareness when it comes to complying with the Data Privacy Act.
I know it may be difficult for you to check all of the companies if they are compliant, but for those who are not complying still, what are the possible penalties they could face?
Right now, we already have, we already in effect, the fines. We implemented, we already have the circular for the schedule of fine, for the fines. So there are certain amount that they need to, when they are not compliant, they will be penalized.
Would you know how much those fines are?
Yes, sir. It would depends on how the gravity of their non-compliance. We have the 0.2% to 5% of their annual income.
That's kind of painful. That's
that
kind
is
of painful. Very good. Very good. How about SMEs? I saw a list of things that corporations have to submit or to set up, like, and also staffing requirements just for protection of data. Can SMEs comply? That's a really long list and very difficult, I believe, for smaller corporations.
Yes, actually, what we do is that we provide them with, there are compliance checks. We have a circular when it comes to compliance checks. So when we go to companies, we check first, or we call that privacy suites. Mm-hmm. So we check first if they are compliant with publicly available information. We also ask them to provide documentations and also on-site visit, which is more regularly done by our compliance and monitoring division. So we understand also that these small and medium enterprise or businesses are having a difficulty when it comes to complying. So we provide them with guidance. We provide trainings and also the list that they need to comply.
Is there a possibility of rationalizing that list? Maybe for some smaller, everybody, sometimes smaller corporations, they have
right.
Zoom events,
mm-hmm.
and in Zoom events, mm-hmm. you're required to send all your email addresses, right? So that already requires this company to have that database and how to protect that database, among other things.
Okay, I think it's the first and most important thing that when, for example, collecting for attendance sheets, they have to have a privacy notice at point of collection. That's the minimum requirement, maybe. And also make sure that when they are collecting this information, they have to be protected. If they are having collecting this and storing this in an Excel file, the laptop should have at least password and antivirus so that the hacking incidents or unauthorized access will be prevented.
Roran, with the rapid acceleration of digitalization and with what you told us, the low manpower
of
the NPC in
trying to regulate all of
right,
the corporations.
Trying to check everything. Yeah. How's the NPC actually catching up and trying to secure privacy of people online?
I'm sorry, I didn't. The line was cut.
Right,
sorry.
Okay. With the rapid acceleration of digitalization, how is the NPC catching up and trying to secure people's privacy?
Okay, we are, first of all, it's also important to address the need to awareness and education among the citizens. so that they can also protect themselves. And for those companies and individuals who are collecting personal data, we provide issuances, guidelines, advisory opinions that they can use as reference and guide them when they are collecting personal data.
Yeah, I think that an article came out today just because if you're not able to do that and companies are not able to comply and all our data reside in their servers, right? And I think there's an article that came out today that the cost of data breaches can go up to, how much was that, Ron? $1 billion something?
$3 million.
Okay, that was way over the amount. So $3 million,
ASEAN
painful.
In the Philippines, yeah.
I think $3 million is, it depends on how big is the company, but the bigger the company, it's the reputational cost is more important to them. So some of the bigger companies are more compliant because they don't want their reputation to be jeopardized.
Okay. You mentioned a while ago that it's not commensurate, the number of people that the MPC has to check up on everything and all of the companies and to secure everyone's data for companies and for establishments. Is there a wish list that the MPC wants from the national government for you to be able to have a stronger mandate in portraying your role?
Yes, actually we are planning to have a reorganization and expansion of the National Privacy Commission so that we will have more offices in our regional and provinces. And this way, it will be easier for companies and data subjects to ask for support and help from the national government, from the National Privacy Commission. Right now, what we are doing is digitalizing every services that we have. For example, filing a complaint, you just need to go to our website and download the form. You can send it online. So you don't really need to go to our office, which is located in the PICC here in Pasay City. We have so much to ask for from the national government, especially for the funding that we have, so that we can go from one province to another.
Yeah. For something very, very important, especially in this age of scams and a lot of cyber attacks. Let me move on to the PhilSys ID. I know that a lot of companies, a lot of movements, a lot of advocacies are depending on the national ID system to improve financial inclusion, among many other things. You know, I don't know if this is a very personal question. I received mine and it was placed in an open envelope. Isn't this dangerous?
The role of the National Privacy Commission when it comes to PhilSys is actually to provide support and during the enforcement. The primary implementer is the Philippines Statistics Authority. So we provide them guidance on how to protect the personal data of the people and also how to collect and safely provide IDs to the citizen.
So that should not have been done. I don't know how many people now have a copy of my national ID. Right. All right. I don't know if we don't have space for any more questions. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We're very grateful for the insights that you have given us.
Thank you so much for inviting NPC again. Maraming salamat.
Thanks, Lauren.